My name is Deanna Shislak. I am the program manager for the Parent and Family Education Programs here at Lehigh Valley Health Network. I am also a nationally certified car seat technician. Today we're going to look at installing a rear-facing car seat. The American Academy of Pediatrics and Pennsylvania law recommend that children ride in the back seat of the vehicle in a rear-facing car seat until the age of 2, or until they reach the maximum weight and height limit for the seat. Rear-facing is the safest option for infants and babies whose skeletal systems are still developing. Here are a few tips to help you get ready. Carefully follow the instructions and details in the owner's manual for both the car seat and the vehicle. Pay special attention to the height and weight limits of your car seat, which can be found in the instructions and on the labels on the side of your car seat. If your car seat is new, be sure to register it with the manufacturer. If you have a used car seat, make sure it has not been recalled or in an accident and it is not expired. All car seats are good for a minimum of 6 years. Not all car seats are alike, but I'll briefly demonstrate installing the base in the vehicle. Never place a rear-facing car seat in a position where there is an active airbag. For new babies, be sure to install the car seat at the correct angle of 45 degrees by using the angle indicator on the car seat. The correct angle will help to keep your new baby's head back to keep the airway open. To install the car seat, you can use either the vehicle seat belt or the lower anchors. One or the other, not both. Both methods are equally safe, so choose the one that gives you a tight and secure fit. Be sure that your child's seat is securely attached to your vehicle by pulling on the seat where it is attached to the vehicle. The car seat should not move more than 1 inch side to side or front to back. Most rear-facing seats will have movement at the top of the seat as they are designed to dump during a crash. Now let's review by placing the child in the car seat. Only use the head and body support pillows and harness protectors that come with the car seat. The harnesses for a rear-facing car seat should come out of the slots on the back of the seat so that they are slightly below the baby's shoulders. Place the baby with normal everyday clothes into the car seat. Now pull the harnesses up and over the hips and the shoulders. Close the buckle at the crotch, then close the retainer clip. Use the adjuster strap to pull the slack out of the harnesses for a snug fit. The harnesses should be snug, not tight, as the baby needs room to breathe in and breathe out. Next, we are going to do the pinch test with the harness straps located at the baby's chest area. You should not be able to pinch any harness in this area. You also want to be sure the harnesses have no twists and that they are laying flat on top of baby's normal, everyday clothes. No bulky jackets or snowsuits under these harnesses. And finally, move the retainer clip to the underarm area. A few other tips. If necessary and allowed by the car seat manufacturer, place rolled blankets for positioning on the sides of the baby and at the crotch buckle to fill in any gap. Check to see where the manufacturer wants the carrying handle to be placed while driving in the vehicle. Make sure you can get your hand between the car seat and the front vehicle seat. Secure anything loose in the vehicle, diaper bags, shopping bags, purses, ice scrapers, should all be secured in the trunk or cargo area under a cover or net. And remember, never leave your child unattended in a car seat, inside or outside of the vehicle. We encourage you to get your car seat checked before the baby arrives, as child safety seats can be challenging to use and install. Call 888-402-LVHN or 800-CAR-BELT to schedule a car seat check with a certified technician. Thank you for watching. To learn more, visit lvhn.org/raisingafamily.